Let's take a look at browser pivoting. Here we are in Kali Linux with our foothold on WS1 as the user Jim Stevens. Let's interact with this beacon and let's ask it for a screenshot so we can check in on what Jim is up to. And when this beacon phones home, we will get a screenshot. We can see that Jim Stevens is currently using Internet Explorer, and Jim is logged into his company email with Roundcube and his personal email with Yahoo. Okay, interesting. We can take advantage of browser pivoting to access these websites authenticated as Jim Stevens. And that's what I'm going to show you right now. So first things first, we need to set up the browser pivot itself. Let's do a sleep zero to task our beacon to check in interactively. Because a browser pivot is very much tunneling things through our beacon session. And let's set up the browser pivot agent. Let's right click, go to explore, browser pivot. And we need to inject the browser pivot into one of the Internet Explorer child tabs. No big deal, that's one of these with the check mark next to it. Let's bind this to port 9000, press launch, and away we go. So now that our browser pivot proxy server is running on port 9000, we need to point a browser at it. What I recommend you use today is Chromium. I recommend you use Chromium because there is an option that you can use, ignore certificate errors. And what ignore certificate errors will do is allow you to browse to an SSL enabled website without getting prompted. In some cases, prompts that you can't bypass. So ignore certificate errors makes this feature a lot better to use. You can also use the dash dash proxy server option on the command line to point Chromium to a specific proxy server. So that's what I'm going to do. Stand up Chromium right now. And here we are. Now, let's go ahead and try to browse to something that Jim is using. Let's go to www.acme.com. And if we go down to webmail login, you will see we are logged into Jim Stevens' email. So that is an example of browser pivoting at its simplest level. And we can use this to write emails to people too. So just sending an email through a browser pivot, kind of cool. Let's take a look at jumping over to yahoo.com so I can show you what it's like to browser pivot when we are in a browser that actually allows us to do things. So let's go over to www.yahoo.com and you can see we are being told that we're not secure because there are certificate errors. But because of that ignore certificate errors flag, we're still able to get to this website. And by the way, if we click over here, go to certificate, you can see this is the certificate for browser pivoting. All right, let's go ahead and jump over to the webmail just to demonstrate that, hey, I can jump into Jim Stevens' webmail and start clicking around and doing things. And we do not care about customizing the look of our inbox. Let's hit send. And so that's just an example of playing around with a modern web application using browser pivoting. Yes, this is an older technology, but it definitely still works if you happen to have the right browser configuration. So that is browser pivoting.